talk about the best of the best of all the best. Justice Payne, the Combat Zone Wrestling World Heavyweight Champion. Look at how this kid has changed since 2 years ago when him and Gage came down here to catch a ride for the Tag Team Championship. But he's getting in the ring with the IPW Heavyweight Champion, Billy Fives. These two guys are physical specimens, and they are the best of the best, and I'm proud to have them here on IPW Hardcore Wrestling.
No, Ron, it's just a title versus title, IPW versus CZW.
It is a Combat Zone Wrestling Heavyweight Championship versus IPW's Heavyweight Championship. Whoever comes out of this match, the victor will be the Unified Champion. And look at them, they come out exchanging punches. These two are both known for their technical wrestling abilities. Justice Payne, oh my God, huge leg lariat drops Justice Payne.
You know, before the match, these fans who are watching recap did not get to see is both of these guys just lambasting IPW. I don't know if they necessarily want the titles. None of them, they said they both.
I don't get it. I don't get it. Billy Fives is the IPW Heavyweight Champion, and he's out here ripping on the fans. He's ripping on the office. He's ripping on the Plex. Justice Payne, I understand. There's been a lot of bad blood with Combat Zone and IPW Hardcore for over 2 years now. From when the Shane Brothers went up there and destroyed Combat Zone to when Nick Gage and Justice Payne came down here and captured the tag belts.
And I have to apologize for that, Ron. I mean, it was mine and Havoc's wrong, you know, doing on why they did.
Yeah, it was your fault.
I'm sorry.
Your doing. I had nothing to do with it. Oh, huge. Look at the stiff elbows by Billy Fives. Just taking, but Justice Payne, he's not stopping something.
That was a huge belly to belly, but it just almost threw him out of the ring. Can you believe that?
These guys might not be 6'9", 6'10". The physical conditioning and the shape that they've got. Oh my God. That comes from those tours of Japan.
Come on, get down there.
Come on, mullet. I talked to Star Stevens after this match, and everything's going crazy, and the mullet thought he had everything well in hand. Star Stevens said straight to me, Ronnie, the mullet ain't cut out for matches such as that.
And I heard it. He said it, those exact words.
Absolutely. Justice Payne and Billy Fives, they might be some of the best cops.
Dropped him right on his knee.
Every time I start saying something, it's some huge move. Look at that clothesline takes Justice Payne right out of his boots. Justice Payne is known as one of the most ultra-violent wrestlers in the business. That's why they call him the ultra-violent Justice Payne. But look at the technical wrestling ability. Look at him dropped on his neck and destroyed. This kid... Come on, Billy. Come on, mullet. You got to keep... I might not like Billy Fives, but you got to keep that IPW heavyweight title right here at the WrestlePlex.
Yeah, you certainly don't like Billy Fives. Oh, my God, look at that. Because you put him in a match tomorrow night, if he gets by tonight, tomorrow night against David Young.
At the Crystal River National Guard Armory, the return of the madness. The boys are back in town. The IPW Heavyweight Championship will be defended. I don't care if it's Billy Fives. I don't care if it's Justice Payne. I don't care. Look at how many times can he miss a clothesline. Look at double clothesline again.
That's what happens when you miss them.
See, that's what happens when you study the tapes. That's what happens when you learn everything about your opponent. They keep ducking. They keep... Oh, there goes the mullet in the way once again.
He should have been ducking there.
Justice Payne said,
Him right on his head.
What the hell do you call that? That's the painkiller applied by Justice Payne, and he absolutely destroys Billy Fives and has him down for at least a 10 count, but the mullet is destroyed over in the corner, leveled by the boots of one Billy Fives.
How is Billy Fives moving? He should be in a body bag right now. This is amazing.
I'll tell you, man, I don't know what...
It's a raindrop right onto Richie Rich. He used him as a weapon. That's the greatest thing I've ever seen.
And he has him covered for about an 8 or 9 count, and there's no mullet. Come on, mullet. Get up. And that's all he did was get leveled by their boots. Shake it off. Get up. You're talking about one of the best heavyweight championship matches we've seen at the WrestlePlex. And Billy Fives slaps him across the face and says, let's go, brother. I had him beat. I defended this title. And there goes the mullet again in the way. Justice, you know what? I'm starting to think Justice Payne took him off purpose.
What is Concession Boy? What is Concession Boy doing?
Well, these two have decided to form some type of unholy unit and have formed an alliance, and now they're destroying Concession Boy.
When the students get in the ring, you know, what are these guys? They go out there to help Richie Rich, and look at these guys just destroying them. That's how much they disrespect IPW. They're going to sit there and try to take out the students with Concession Boy.
There's a big difference between taking out the students and the WrestlePlex and Concession Boy compared to taking out the Shane Brothers and the Hardcore Giant. You're talking about the biggest, baddest individuals in IPW, and they're going to take it. Oh, my God, they're getting to take it to them by Fives and Payne. But they reverse it on them, and there's two huge clotheslines. Oh, my God. Naftali, I know you're in awe. I know you're in shock. You're probably scared for your body. You're going to fight the huge pancake right on his face. The Shane brothers and the hardcore giant Rocky, they're not going to take it from Combat Zone. They're not going to take it from Billy Fives. This is the future of IP.
Oh!